We are now going to discuss what happens during the interface startup process. What are the minimum set of information that we need to configure both on the interface as well as the pipe point, and how we can set the scan frequency for querying the data source. So let's have a situation where we have three different nodes, one for our PyData archive, another one for interface and data source. So you start the interface. So the first step, what it will do is it's going to inquire with the PyData archive, give me the set of points. This is step number one. Because on an interface node, you can have multiple interfaces, right? So it can be talking to different data sources, pointing to the same PyData archive. So there should be a kind of a mechanism to basically tie the interface with a set or subset of points which is residing on the PyData archive. The way we do it is there are some placeholders which we configure on the interface, which is called point source and interface ID. And likewise, we configure exactly the same way for the set of points which belongs to this interface on the PyData archive with the same point source and interface ID. Now, the interface acquires the list of points. This is step two from the PyData archive based upon point source. And then it queries the data source for tag values. So now the question is, okay, you can name your tags whatever you want. How are you going to basically supply the information to the data source saying that, okay, give me the point value for this particular tag, because on the data source it can be called something else. So the way we do it is we have another identifier which we configure on the pipe point, which is called instrument tag. And we map it to something called item ID. This is basically the name of the tag on the data source, item ID. So this item ID lives on the data source. So the tag values will be returned to the interface based upon this tag ID, item ID. So this will be step number four. The values gets returned to the interface. And finally, interface pushes the value to the PyData archive. Step number five. So this is the complete process. So the question is, why do we require two different attributes, namely the point source and interface ID, to basically tie the set of points between the interface and the PyData archive? The reason being is for load balancing. Let's assume a situation where we have about 20,000 points belonging to this interface or belonging to the data source where we want to get the values from. You don't want to bombard the data source all at the same time. And at the same time, you don't want to, you know, increase the network traffic. So for that purpose, I can load balance. I can divide the set of tags into 10,000 and 10,000. And the first set 10,000 tags, I can give it a point source, an interface ID. PS is the short form, OPC, and item ID, I can specify as one. And likewise, for the other one, I can specify the point source as OPC and interface ID as two. Finally, I can configure, instead of just one interface instance, I can create two interface instances, interface one and interface two. So we have these two interfaces which are running. So this particular interface would utilize the first 10,000 based upon point source and interface ID, and the second 10,000 will be utilized for utilizing the same point source but a different interface ID. So that's how we can load balance. And we can basically say, okay, the first interface, I can scan it at a specific interval in time or a specific point in time. And the second interface instance, I can configure and basically have it scan the data source at a different time so that there won't be any collisions in terms of querying the data source all 20,000 tags at the same time. So let's now talk very briefly about the concept of scanning the data source. On the interface side, we configure something called a scan class. This can be represented either by specifying the scan frequency or by having a set of scan frequency plus an offset, scan offset. Let's assume two different kinds of scenarios. So let's say, okay, I want to have a scan frequency every 1 minute. 00, 01, 00. This is every 1 minute. So let's assume that the interface is started at 8 a.m. in the morning. So the interface is going to scan the data source. The first scan is going to happen based upon this rule at 8:01 a.m. That is the first scan. And 8:02 is the second scan. So 8:02 a.m. and going forward. Let's see about another scenario. So let's take up another scan class where it is a combination of scan frequency and offset. So let's have it something like this. So let's have it every 1 minute, the same as before, as a scan frequency. But we will add an offset as 9 hours. 09, 00, 00. So similar to the previous one, we start the interface at 8 a.m. in the morning. So based upon this, the first scan is not going to happen immediately at 8:01 a.m. But instead, it goes through the following algorithm. So we start at midnight on the day we start the interface. We then add the offset, which is 09, 00, 00. From that time onwards, we march forward by adding the frequency. So we add the frequency, and now it should be 01, 00, 09, 02, 00. So based upon this, the first scan is going to happen at 9:01, and second scan, it is going to happen at 9:02 and going forward. So that is how the interface would work if you just have a scan frequency compared to a scan frequency plus an offset.